Okay, so Pramer, let's us share your intro experience of MS in Material Science, IIT Gandhinagar. But before that, Pramer, your brief academic introduction.
Okay, sir. Sir, I am Shivam Pramar from Ludhiana, and I have completed my BTech in Mechanical Engineering from Baba Banda Singh Bahadur Engineering College with 81% marks. And after that, in GATE exam, so this year my score was 537 with general category. And I have appeared in various IIT interviews, and this time I'm going to share interview experience for IIT Gandhinagar Material Science, and
Okay.
that was for MS course.
Okay. Shivam, what is your GATE score?
537, sir.
537. Okay. So far, from where you got the calls, other calls, Pramar?
I have got calls from IIT BHU from two of the departments, that is mechanical and one was biomedical engineering for MTech, and two calls from Gandhinagar. One was for PhD in mechanical with heat transfer as specialized domain, and another is for work study program. This is a 3-year course, MS, and this is for material science.
Great. So this is work study program, right?
Yes, sir, work study program.
So this work study program 3 years is different from MS program or what?
This is spelled as MTech work study, but this is a MS program, basically 3-year program.
But
And
more
in this,
scholarship.
yes, with more scholarship, it's around 18,000, I believe.
Good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Parmar, let's go ahead now with the intro experience. How was it?
Yes, sir. Experience for materials science MS interview was very, very nice from my side. So whatsoever they ask, so I thought like I quenched their thirst. So whatsoever whoever was asked, so I answered all the questions. So the interview was conducted in the morning, and two of the professors from the material science background only, and I was supposed to wait in the lobby for approx 30 minutes this time, and my interview was for about 15 to 20 minutes duration.
Okay.
And the first professor started with asked me to introduce myself, where I introduce myself with my academic background and work experience. And later on, they keep on asking questions through manufacturing work experience. So yes, the entire interview went in that direction only. So they didn't ask anything much regarding material science. Only one or two questions were asked, like nanoparticles and nanofluids, something like that they were asking me. And that too they asked like when I in the flow, when I was saying like I have done work in this sector, and then manufacturing, then semiconductor industry. So once I spelled semiconductor, after that they keep on asking me questions related to that nanoparticle, nanofluid. Though I was not having much knowledge about that, so I simply said no. And this question was addressed in the middle. So before that, they after introduction, so they asked me like what was my contribution in the Mat Breaks India Limited, where I was working as a lean production engineer. So we were undergoing some project there. So that was regarding the pressing operation. So when a brake pad, back plate is made up of iron, that is alloy steel, and some mixed material is stick to it. So that is undergone under pressing operation with 400 to 500 tons of pressure. So once I have seen one incident in the industry, like where one of the machine operator puts his hand inside the cylinder by mistake, and both his hands were completely damaged by that time. And I was passing by as a lean engineer. I was passing by the pressing section, so I don't know what comes to my mind, and I simply release the hoses so that the hydraulic pressure is released and the piston may come down. So in that way, his life was saved that day. And later on, we worked in that particular project, like what improvement can be made in that direction. So I explained all these things, like we instead of doing that operation in automatic mode, so we designed it for manual operation so that both the hands are engaged. Like you have to push one button and you have to release one lever so that your hands are engaged, and even by mistake you do not put your hand inside the piston. So that's how we made, and it was recognized as the best POCA UK of the year. So that's how I explained, and they were happy to hear that. And the first professor told me, like, I'll be asking at the start of the interview. So the first professor told me that I'll be asking regarding your profile, regarding your career. So I'll be asking question in that direction, and the another peer will be asking questions related to subject. But then, like, once he was done with me with his part, so later on, when next professor's turn come, so even he started asking me in that direction only. So he was, you know, asking next level questions, like, suppose if I select you in this domain, so, and you see in the lab, like, your seniors are, you know, not using the apparatus in the right format, so what action you will take? So I told them, like, being a lean engineer, so first I'll ensure that all the PPEs are being used, so that the safety of the purpose is ensured, because life of the people is very important as compared to machine. And later on, I told that we'll implement one, we'll make one SOP, and we'll stick it over the machine, so that whenever anybody came, so he'll be using PPEs and reading all the instructions. That was for the you know, whosoever has to undergo some testing operation, something like that. And I said, if even after doing so, if the purpose is not fulfilled, we observe that still people are violating some laws, so we'll ensure that we'll assign some duty to the, you know, some lab operator, so that he'll keep an eye on such such happenings. And later on, we'll discuss with professor, so what further action can be taken in that direction. So this was all regarding my interview, sir. So I think I answered all their questions, and they were looking satisfied.
Shivam, did they ask you anything related to your job, or you were only explained? Any questions, cross question related to your job profile?
Yes, sir. Like, as I said, like, what contribution I made there in during
that
my
job.
That
was the question, huh?
Mm. Yes, that was the job. And,
and BTEC project?
Nothing much, sir. Nothing else was asked, neither from the, you know, material science as a subject, or from the BTEC project itself.
So what do you think, what is the reason? Because material science was the department, and they asked you no question for material science. What do you think is the reason?
I think, sir, they believe that, like, I have applied for work study program, and I'm having some work experience, so I think they think that I'm suitable candidate for this. And being
because, you know, in work study, no, even other students also told me that they were more interested whether you will be in position to handle the labs or not.
Okay.
And since you have more experience of a job, and that too in, I think, production shop or something.
Yes, sir.
So I think they understood that you can handle the lab.
Yes, sir.
That may be one of the reason, actually.
Yes, sir.
So you are the suitable candidate for them, it looks like.
I think so, sir. they were looking satisfied as compared to...
They were looking for people with job experience, I think, for work and study, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Anywhere because, in India, this kind of model is there, work and study? I don't think so.
Till yet, sir, I haven't come across any such program in any of the IIT. But, you know, they are providing higher scholarship value in this particular course. And it was also free of cost application, sir. So nothing, no fees was there. So that's why I applied in two of the departments. And okay. Yes, sir.
Shivam, you mentioned about POCA UK, something like in your job. What is that? Can you explain me if you know?
Yes, sir. So POCA UK is something, sir, that is foolproofing. You know, if some worker is bypassing the system, so some action, or, you know, some improvement is made in the system in such a way so that even by will or by chance, he'll not be in position to, you know, bypass the system. So, like, in pressing, when, you know, you insert the back plates, and after that you have to put the mixed glasses, mixed material inside the cavity. After putting, so there are two types of mix they put. One is the base layer and one is the underlayer. So sometimes what is being observed in the manufacturing, that some of the new workmen that they hire, so they forgot to put the underlayer mix. So So they only put one type of mix in the cavity. So in that case, defects are generated, like thickness will be not up to the mark, and even defects will be there, like porosity and other things. So we ensure, like when another when you know, any machine operator is putting underlayer, after that he has to push a button is implemented over there. So he has to push one, that button. If he doesn't do that, so in that case the machine will not go into pressing.
Okay, yes, that's sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So great, Shivam. So you have shared your intro experience for material science, and yes, I'm very sure you're going to get selected in this. And
I hope so, sir.
Yeah. So which other intros in pipeline for you now?
Right now, sir, I'm preparing SOP for management studies PhD course that is for IIT Delhi, sir.
Did you apply for IIT Kanpur Industrial Management?
Yes, sir. I have applied in all IITs, sir, for this domain. And
I think also, Industrial Management, IIT Kanpur, the list have started coming for students. I don't know.
Yes, sir.
Just check for yourself.
Okay, sir. Yeah. And I have also applied for photonics, sir. As you mentioned, like photonics is a nice branch. And somehow I related that to my job profile also, like lithography and something like that. Okay. So that's how I made the SOP. So I am expecting call from, Delhi and Kanpur from the same department, sir.
Great. Yes, Chalo, Shivam, thanks a lot for sharing your intro experience, and keep sharing others also.
Sure, sir. My pleasure, sir.